is driving change with leadership in transport industry.
Eternal rock of ages, we bless and we exalt your holy name. Thank you, Lord, for the young man you have proudly used even to make this gathering possible. We pray that your plan and your purpose for today alone be made manifest in this place in the name of Jesus.
I want to welcome you all to this inaugural transport leadership lecture, organized by King's Communication Limited, in collaboration with the Federal Minister of Transport, with the team Driving Change Agenda with Leadership in Transport Industry. I seek your permission to jump over 100 years of leadership research that brought about appreciating the concept of leadership through three key approaches, which are personality, behavior, and situational context as drivers of leadership. In an industry-wide pool of 105 respondents, Shippers Council has 75%, 17% could not take a stand, 10% settled for Nigerian Ports Authority, other agencies had no score, especially NIMASA, which at that time was looted by every Nigerian as a result of mindless looting of it by its leadership. While NIMASA was bleeding, the Nigerian Airspace Management Agency was smelling with over 16 billion naira fraud. On this note, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the guest lecturer, the chairman of the event, other wonderful men, women seated here, I welcome you all to this inaugural leadership lecture. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, our resource person today is Professor David Adamu Baike, former Vice Chancellor, University of Benin.
I would like to accept responsibility entirely for whatever shortcomings may be noticed in the paper that is about to be read. To understand the topic of the lecture itself, and my understanding of it is such that has made my ability to deliver very inadequate, but I hope we will share in some thoughts together. I have brought along with me a very good friend of mine, one of the young men who have risen up the scale in the person of Professor Dauda Ishaya to help me read the paper.
Before I proceed to read the paper, the guest speaker warned me strictly that I should try as much as possible to present his paper undiluted, Driving Change Agenda with Leadership in Transport Industry. He started the paper by saying, implicit in the topic of this address is the suggestion that those at the helm of the transport industry subscribe to the idea or concept of the ongoing change agenda subject. However, to having a leadership that will drive the change to its desired goal. The word change is a simple word. The many variations in meaning simply illustrate how the word can be used in different circumstances. In a nutshell, change simply means to become different, to make a difference from one situation to another for the better. However, the use of the word change to effect a difference from a given situation to another may have some serious implications or very demanding conditions without which the desired change may not be readily attained. For example, if you want to change an old padlock with a new one, there is no big deal in effecting such a change. But where the change affects human endeavor, account must be taken of the reasons for the change, the circumstances, and certainly whether the new entrant is suitably qualified and is capable of effecting the change envisaged. Change for the sake of change is not compatible with change to make a difference. In my many forays, in the course of my duty, I have been privileged to enjoy the facilities of many transport industries, but that does not make me knowledgeable in the nuances of transportation industry. I apologize for my shortcomings. And I hope my journey from here to the airport will be led by a car with a siren to ensure that I catch my flight on time. Thank you, Professor Adamubi.
That the Nigerian Shippers Council has been nominated and voted the best maritime agency of the year 2015. Thank you very much.
Shippers Council is most deserving of this award. It is my personal honor and pleasure to also acknowledge my brother and my friend, Mr. Hassan Bello, and to present this award to the Nigerian Shippers Council.
This is Kings Communications Limited. And all of you gathered here today for this award, may God bless all of us.
Members of this distinguished assembly, I want to say thank you all for all your contributions, for being here with us, for staying with us, and for your support to King's Communication. We'll say a big thank you. Thank you very much.
Oh, we're on our way, we're on everywhere. Minister, not ministries in country, taking charge. So the issue of transport policy will address, but when are we going to do it? We are still dreaming. When are we going to give birth to this dream? A single man single-handedly in Singapore did a lot of miracle and magic there. Like I mentioned in my speech, this man did, he built roads, he built airports, he built a lot of things. Okay, it's all leadership. He had a vision.
King's Communication, first of all, invited a speaker outside of the normal voices that we have all heard, so that we can at least have some new insights and new perspectives to the issues that are relevant to the transportation sector. So I'm very pleased that he did that.
This is good, but we have had several in the years past. We have had committees set up, the report of which we don't know.
Being an inaugural event of such, I think it came out wonderfully. It's beautiful.
The essence of today's event is to talk about two things, the leadership and the change element. Right.